Hello everyone. In this quick video, we will learn how to determine whether a system is consistent and how to identify the type of solution for consistent systems. A system that has no solution is called inconsistent, whereas a system is consistent if it has at least one solution. Consistent systems can have either one unique solution or infinitely many solutions. We can determine whether a system is consistent, as well as to identify the type of solution for a consistent system from the reduced row echelon form of the augmented matrix. Here are the steps. First, construct the augmented matrix of the system. Then, carry it to reduced row echelon form, or REF. Next, check if any of the rows is in the following form, where all the rows entries corresponding to the coefficients are zeros, but the row's entry corresponding to the constant is non-zero. If the answer is yes, then the system is inconsistent. If the answer is no, then the system is consistent. Here's an example of the REF of the augmented matrix of an inconsistent system. Notice that in row 3, all the entries corresponding to the variable's coefficients are zeros, while the entry corresponding to the constant is 6. Recall that each column of the augmented matrix corresponds to the numerical coefficients of the variables in the system. So if we convert row 3 to an equation, we will get 0 equals 6, which is clearly not true. Therefore, the system has no solution. As for the consistent systems, turns out we can also identify the type of solution from the number of leading ones, which is referred to as the rank, in the reduced row echelon form matrix. If each column of the reduced row echelon form of the augmented matrix has a leading one, the system has a unique solution. In other words, if the number of leading ones is equal to the number of variables in the system, then the system has only one solution. Note that in the given example, each column corresponding to the variables has a leading one, and thus the number of leading ones equal to the number of variables in the system. This system has only one solution. On the other hand, if not all columns have a leading one, which means the number of leading ones is less than the number of variables, there will be parameters in the solution, and thus the system will have infinitely many solutions. The number of parameters in the solution is the difference between the number of variables and the number of leading ones, or the rank of the augmented matrix. In this example, there are 2 leading ones, while there are 3 variables in the system. Therefore, the solution will be parametric, with x3 being the only free variable. Thanks for watching.